Hello viewers, in this session I'm going to show you how to create an interactive video. Integrate some kind of quizzes and polls in between the video. Why we need to do this actually? Basically, you might have heard about blended classroom and flipped classroom activities where to increase students' interaction we are performing some activities, right? So one of the activity is a flipped classroom activity where a teacher used to share a video link to the student, and the student will watch that particular video in their home, and then in the next day they will come up with some idea regarding that video. And in the classroom, a real-time problem statement or else some kind of homework task will be given and which will be discussed and solved, and finally the teacher will summarize the problems and issues with that. So it is a kind of reverse learning, means a homework will be done in the classroom and then, you know, video learning will be done in the home. Alright, now we're gonna do three steps. Step one is sign up, and step two we are going to create a video, and in step three we're gonna see how to track the responses and all. So to start with step one, first of all you need to log into www.vizia.co and click login button, and you can create an account over here or else you can use your existing Gmail account to sign up. Alright, the step one is done, and once if you log in you will land up in this page. So this is step two. We are going to create a new video where it's logout and feedback, invite, my video, new video tabs over here. So these are the videos I have created in the past. So to create a new video you need to click new video tab, and it will take you to a new page where you have to provide a link from our YouTube source. So you just go to YouTube and copy paste the URL of that particular link for which you want to create an activity. So but make sure that video is under Creative Commons license. So if you don't know how to select a Creative Commons license video, I'll post in another video. Please check my YouTube channel. So click continue, and you can name this as Java programming, and click update. Once if you do this, the name will get changed over here. You can see this. Yep. And the video will get loaded here, and just play the video and check where you can embed some quizzes over here. So these are the options like quiz, poll, response or call to action to create within this video. So for demo purpose I'm just, so for example this is my first slide, and my second slide starts over here. In the sense, now I need to ask a question from first slide. So you just click here somewhere here and click on the video so that it will get paused, and now place your timeline exactly over there, cursor, and you just click on quiz, and you just add the question like I have already having a notepad just to save some time. And I'm gonna paste all these options over here. You can create some something like this, some different options. Done. So now you have to choose the correct answer for this question also, because finally we are going to rank it. Click save button so that the question will get saved, and play the video again, and wherever you want to embed a video causing the video. And I just want to make one more question over here. Pause the video and place your cursor exactly over there, or else even here if you want, or here. I need exactly here, like 3 minutes 50 seconds, and go to quiz, click on quiz, and I'm gonna have another question like what is polymorphism and many forms, or else I'll type single form, simple. Okay, done. So and save this question. Have done. Okay, so everything is done now, and you can play the video if you want. If you want to add one more question, you can do it. Okay, done. That's it. So this is from teacher's side. So once this is done, you can share this link. So click here, and then you can share this link to the students. Or if you want to preview, you can click it. Click the preview button. So it will take you to this preview page where you can play.
Hello friends, I'm Ravi here, and today we are going to learn about the OOPS concept.
Yep. So I'll directly take you to the question. So what happens, we'll see. So
OOPS.
And whenever the question pops up, your video will get stopped automatically. You have to answer the question. The student have to answer the question. Even they can skip if they want and click continue. But if they skip, that particular question won't get marked. Ranked
in term like
continue and they will continue with this, and the video goes on. So this kind of activity will keep them active.
The OOPS concept part 2,
and again the second question pops up. Okay,
provide more details about it.
So once at the end of the video, it will show the results to the students also, like for out of 2 I got 1 mark. Okay. And this response will get recorded over here. So you can see responses. If I refresh the video, the step 3 is to view the responses from student side. So the teacher can refresh the link, and it will be showing you like this responses, number of responses. As of now it is 1. And just click download CSV, an Excel file will get downloaded. Just open the Excel sheet, so there's like timestamp, what time they have attended the question, and their name and their email and the questions and answers which they have responded. The main thing is the video link won't get expired. All the videos will get stored under My Videos tab, and then if you want to view a student's response maybe even after a day, for instance for this particular video in the sense, just click on the video, and again you can click download CSV button so that an updated CSV file will get downloaded. And this is one of a nice activity. Try this and let me know the responses from student side. Thank you.